There are many ways to roll up a character in D&D 5th edition: the standard array, the point buy, or the classic 4d6 drop lowest per attribute. I've even seen interesting methods like only roll 3d6 per ability and live with it, or maybe roll 7 times and drop the lowest sum. I've even seen something like roll 4d6, drop lowest, add a bonus for your main stat, and roll 3d6 with a minus for your other stats. I even know some people who do something like 3d6 plus 2, or 1d10 plus 8, or just roll a straight 1d20 per ability. I don't really get that last one. But most of these feel just uninspired, old, and even a bit too complicated. And a friend of mine who is opposed to rolling says that he only gets banal, okay at everything characters. Another method I tried before is having all players roll 3d6 7 times to make sure no one gets a really low score, and then collect all the results in a pool. Then they each in turn choose a result and assign it. Yes, this will usually result in slightly more powerful than average characters, but this sort of score drafting discussion is a cool minigame between the players at the table that allows for more choice and interaction. If rolling 7 times per player gives them too much choice, you can tell them to roll it 6 times and then add 3-4 rolls yourself. But a little ways back, I came across a new method which I like very much and have been using exclusively since. It's called the ring method. The idea goes something like this. You roll 24d6. You arrange all the individual results in a ring in the order in which they came. Then you look at the ring of numbers you got, pick 3 consecutive ones, take them out, sum them up, close the ring. Repeat this 6 times until you get all your ability scores. If you want to be more generous, you can roll 27d6, and if you want to be more sadistic, you can roll 21d6. This usually leads to characters with roughly the same level of power as if you're using the 4d6 drop lowest, but there is randomness there and also choice. A little minigame for the players, to see what kind of character they can get. They can choose, and it's encouraged, to get 3 low numbers out of the ring so they can bring together 3 higher numbers, thus creating more interesting and nuanced characters. It's especially a great addition for those who like to manage some mechanics and put their spin on things even before you start the game. I really hope you'll try this method next time you make a new character, and then come back here, comment, and tell me how it went. Thank you very much for watching. Please like and subscribe so these kinds of videos can reach more people. I'll see you next time. Stay good. Have fun.